Think about that special person in your life whom you love the most, with the presence of whom you do not require anybody or anything else to be happy. He or she is so full of fun and cheerful that with their presence you spring back with fun. He or she is that one person who is also your model, or whom you admire, or whom you value the most. Now imagine one fine day when you go to meet that person. He does not respond so well, looks very depressed or gloomy. It might be a sudden thing one fine day, but surely would break your heart to miss that valued connect with the person who made you realize the beauty of life. It might just be a bad day for him, but it might also be a start of a condition which we are going to discuss in this video. The Alzheimer's. Alzheimer's disease is named after Dr. Alois Alzheimer. It was in the year 1901 when Dr. Alzheimer noticed this unusual behavior of a lady patient, Auguste Deter, which led him to interview more about this strange disease. In 1906, Dr. Alzheimer noticed significant changes in the brain tissue of this woman who had died of unusual mental illness. Her symptoms included memory loss, language problems, and unpredictable behavior. He observed major irregularities in the structure of brain tissue, which consisted numerous misfolded proteins called plaques and neurofibrillary tangles made up of tau protein. We know that brain nerve cells and microtubules in neurons are the way sensory signals communicate inside brain with a lightning fast speed. However, in this condition, tau begins to pair with other threads of tau. This may result first in malfunctions in biochemical communications between neurons and later in death of these cells. Thus, in Alzheimer's disease, changes in tau protein lead to disintegration of microtubules in brain cells, thus resulting in gradual shrinking of the size of the brain. It is the most common cause of dementia. Affecting over 40 million people every year in the world, and around 10 million people in India alone. Yet, a concrete cure for it hasn't been yet discovered, but just a few drugs to slow its effects down. Like all types of dementia, Alzheimer's is caused by brain cells' death. It is a neurodegenerative disease, which means there is a progressive brain cell death that happens over a course of time. The total brain size shrinks with Alzheimer's. The tissue has progressively fewer nerve cells and connections. Now the question is, how will you be able to diagnose it? Let's look at the stages to understand. People often tend to misunderstand normal aging with Alzheimer's disease. Common signs of aging, apart from aging itself, include forgetting things occasionally, misplacing items sometimes, minor short-term memory loss, not remembering exact details. Now, the early stages of Alzheimer's include not remembering, episodes of forgetfulness, forgets names of family and friends. Now, these changes can be noticed by close friends and relatives. Some confusion in situations outside the familiar. Middle stages of Alzheimer's include greater difficulty remembering recently learned information, deepening confusion in many circumstances, problems with sleep, trouble knowing where they are, and tendency of getting lost at times. Now, late stages of Alzheimer's include poor ability to think, problems speaking, repeats same conversations, more abusive, anxious, paranoid or schizophrenic. Worse scenarios may even lead to suicidal attempts. This is where they need most attention and care. Now there comes the caregivers into picture. Caregivers are the people who in this case are the most sufferers along with the patient. The patients here look absolutely normal, but they are not normal people. They are most helpless patients who don't even understand their situation and are very helpless and dependent on others, especially the caregivers, for everything. The more pity is because their appearance looks pretty normal, but people judge them with their abnormal behaviors, which is only due to Alzheimer's condition. Hence, don't mistake them to be normal and get angry on them due to their behavior. Don't hate them, don't make them aloof, and don't leave them alone. Because they are as innocent as a child who doesn't even know what they are doing. They need your support, care, and affection to live till the last day, after which you will miss them forever. While you can pray and thank God that you don't have Alzheimer's and can still perceive your valued relations. Stay blessed and keep spreading love. I'll see you in the next one. Take care. Bye-bye.